Welcome to English Spoken Cafe. My name is Bash. I'm an English teacher. This is my good friend Alton. I have not seen him in 3 years. I just came to visit him after a long time. So I thought we might use this opportunity to teach you all some phrases for seeing somebody after a long time. First one, once in a blue moon. Once in a blue moon, I will come and see Alton, my friend, who lives very far away. Yes, but only once in a blue moon. Why? Because blue moons are apparently very rare. They don't occur very frequently. Once in a blue moon. Okay, second phrase.
Okay, the second phrase was for donkey's years.
For donkey's years. And how would we use this in a sentence with you and me?
You know, I don't know really. Do you have an example?
Oh, God, yeah, it's been donkey's years since I saw Alton, or like, he and I have been working together in some capacity for donkey's years. Why? Because apparently, a year in a donkey's life is very long.
You know, I didn't know that, because when you told me now, a year in a donkey's life is a very long time, so that's why.
It's interesting, because animals, like, their time span does not correspond to that of humans, so their sense of 1 year, like a cat's year, or a dog's ear is different from a human's ear.
Cat's ears would be possible to, you know, it's a long time.
Is it? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool, yeah.
What's the third phrase?
The third phrase is, long time no see. It actually doesn't make grammatical sense, long time no see. Like, it can't really function as a sentence. But it is a genuine phrase that we use as natives.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's like, hello, how are you? Long time no see, if I haven't seen you in a long time.
You know, sometimes it should be, you know, it doesn't have to be grammatically correct.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, instead we would probably say, I haven't seen you for a very long time.
That's more grammatically.
You know, but it would be boring if you say, long time no see, bro, which is more fun.
It's more fun, and also it's shorter, you know, when you're greeting especially a lot of people, you know, you don't want to, your greetings have to be short. You don't have, it takes a lot of time and energy to kind of put out a full sentence when you just see somebody in the beginning. Cool.
Yana, do you want to join us? Come join us, please. Because we are still thinking of some more phrases about...
But I don't know any phrases. Like, I cannot help you.
Okay, let's think together, because we are here to think about it.
This is our teacher. Her name is Yaren. Is that correct?
But,
Hello, Yaren.
This is Yaren.
Okay. Yeah, well, yeah.
No, I don't know any phrases. Do not ask me.
Right, okay, well, do you like teaching here?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
But it's funny that he was my first teacher in here.
Right, yeah, your face looks familiar, but I'm trying to recall, like, a specific conversation.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit difficult for me, because when I was here, I had a lot of students.
Yeah, I don't.
But yeah, your face does look familiar.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right.
Okay, we have a guest here.
Right,
guest.
What's this cat's name?
What's your name? Pelush.
Can you introduce yourself, please?
This is Pelush.
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 Does that have a meaning?
It's something like fluffy.
Oh, like fluffy.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you? How is it, boy or girl?
Girl.
She's a princess.
She's a princess.
Yeah.
Excuse me. How old is she? Hello, kitty. Hi. You have to edit this. Oh, is it still recording? You're going to have to edit it later. You know that, right? If you want to put it on the channel.
Hi, kitty. Meow.
Okay, so we started like talking about long time no see and the other phrases, but it gets to something like the phrases and some conversation.
Some conversation with the cat. Yeah, exactly. This is how we talk to cats in England. We just stroke them and we just say random stuff that doesn't follow along.
Hello, kitty.
Okay, maybe we can just say bye to the people.
Yeah, guys. Bye.